We are in September now, so that means a bunch of minor leaguers have been added to the 40-man roster and have been called up for September call-ups. But one bad thing that happened is, right as we got to September call-ups, Reyes Maranta tore a finger ligament, so he is out for the rest of the season. And now the only remaining members of the bullpen from our opening day roster are Mark Melanson and Trevor Gott. The Giants travel out to the Midwest to take on the Cardinals, who have not had the greatest of years, and Shaun Anderson, recently called up from AAA Sacramento, will be making his Major League debut for the Giants. The 6'4 right-hander from the University of Florida making the start, and Dakota Hudson will be opposing him. This is his 19th start of the season for the Cardinals. Lineup for the Cardinals, of course, rounded out, or led, I should say, by Paul Goldschmidt in the three-hole. On the Giants lineup, main changes: Connor Joe in right field, Casey Gillespie at first base getting some looks. So bottom half of the second, Matt Carpenter draws a walk as he does. He has an over 400 OBP on the season. But then Tyler O'Neill grounds over to third base, and Ryan Schimpf showing off some defense with a beautiful turn on the around-the-horn double play. Still score this top of the third, Shaun Anderson comes to the plate, and he is going to show off some hitting skills. Bloops a ball into right field for his first career hit. That brings up Joe Panic to the plate, and the New York native is going to hit a ball into right center field. It's going to get up against the wall. Anderson thinks about trying to score, but he decides not to. Dives back into third as the throw gets over there right behind him. So first and, or second and third, I should say, Posey hits a ball into the hole, and he chugs his way down the first base path. Run comes in. He just barely was safe. Goldschmidt even thought he was out. So it's runners on the corners now, a 1-0 lead, and Brandon Belt is going to ground out to Jairo Munoz over at second base. So 1-0, bottom of the fifth, Tyler O'Neill goes down swinging after that. It brings up Yadier Molina, runner on first. They try the hit and run, but it's going to be a ground out right to Crawford. So now it's runner on second with two outs, and Dakota Hudson goes down swinging. So still 1-0 Giants, moving on to the top of the sixth, where Ryan Schimpf comes to the plate. He goes down swinging on a curveball that gets away from Yachty. Gets to it quickly. They initially call Schimpf out, but on second look, he actually was safe, so they review it, and they call him safe. So Ryan Schimpf reaches on the drop third strike, one out, runner on first. Brandon Crawford hits one the opposite way into left field, so it's first and second now for the Giants. With one out, brings up Connor Joe. He's also going opposite way, him into right field. Everyone will move up one base. That's bases loaded now, as Adam Wainwright comes in the game with one out to replace Dakota Hudson. Casey Gillespie at the plate, up with the September call-ups, and he's going to pop a ball up to the shortstop. Infield fly rule got under that one. Then Chris Shaw comes on to pinch hit for the pitcher spot, and he is going to ground out to first base. Still a 1-0 game as we move on to the bottom of the sixth, where Jairo Munoz is at the plate. He's going to bloop a ball into right field. That's going to skip up over the head of Connor Joe in right, and Munoz is not stopping at second base. That is going to be an easy triple for him. So runner in scoring position for the Cardinals, as Trevor Gott will come on to replace Shaun Anderson. So runner on third, one out. Paul Goldschmidt draws a walk. They were pitching around him. And it's runners on first and third now with one out. Paul DeJong then grounds into a 4-6-3 inning-ending double play. So it's still a 1-0 lead for the Giants. Ray Black comes on in the bottom of the eighth, trying to maintain that lead with two outs. He walks Jose Martinez. He had two quick outs before that, but this is where the inning gets away from him. Harrison Bader then comes on to pinch run, and the hit and run is on with a 2-2 count. And Munoz hits a ball into left center field. It'll get up to the wall. Bader scores easily from first base. It's an RBI double for Munoz. 1-1 ball game now. Then Paul Goldschmidt lines one right at Gillespie, who makes the snag. Harrison Bader stays on for the Cardinals in right field. And Mike Myers comes on out of the pen in the top of the ninth. And Chris Shaw, first pitch he sees from Mike Myers, he's taken that one deep. A long home run for the Massachusetts native, his fourth home run of the season, and the Giants now have a 2-1 lead. Avellino then comes on to pinch hit for the Giants, hits a ball right back up the middle. It's two pitches thrown by Myers, both have given up hits. So Avellino on first base brings up Joe Panic, who's going to bloop a ball into left field just barely fair. Avellino's going first to third, so runners on the corners for Buster Posey. who muscles one out to right field. And that's going to be an RBI single for the Giants. 3-1 is the score. They say that's enough of Myers. They bring in John Brebbia. First and second now. Nobody out still. Brandon Belt then with a hard hit ball over the head of Bader in right field. One run will come in. RBI double for Brandon Belt. It's now a 4-1 game. Second and third, nobody out. Ryan Schimpf draws a walk, so it's now bases juiced for Brandon Crawford, who is 3-for-4 on the day. Make that 4-4-5. That's going to be hit to deep left center field, land in front of the wall, hops up over the wall. A 2 RBI ground rule double. 6-1 is the score. Connor Joe then comes on. He's 2-for-4. And he's going to hit a ground ball over to shortstop. We'll drive in one run to make it 7-1. And we finally get out of that inning. Move on to the bottom of the ninth. Mark Melancon gets into a bit of a jam. Two outs, first and second. But Yadier Molina goes down swinging. And the San Francisco Giants win this one with a huge inning in the top of the ninth by a score of 7-1 here over the St. Louis Cardinals. Brandon Crawford picks up player of the game honors. He was 4-for-5 in the day. He had two doubles. Buster Posey was 3-for-5. Chris Shaw had that one solo shot to give them the lead back in the top of the ninth. While on the Cardinals side of things, they were pretty much led offensively by Jairo Munoz, who was 3-for-4 in the day with a triple, a double, and a run driven in. Giants are now back home at Oracle Park to take on the Pittsburgh Pirates, who are 70-73 on the season. Jeff Samardzija gets the start for the Giants, making his 29th of the year. He's had a good year with a 3.31 ERA. He'll be taking on Chris Archer of the Pirates. And the lineup for the Pirates, very fast one, second in the National League in steals with Marte at the top of it. And then the Giants lineup with new people everywhere, Abel Avellino at second, and then Levi Michael in right field. So bottom of the first inning, Robbie Grossman's going to hit a ball into left center field over the head of everybody, skips up away from Starling Marte, and he's going to be able to get into third base with a leadoff triple. And then Buster Posey does what he does on the second pitch of the game and hits a ball opposite way, drives in the run, and it's now a 1-0 Giants lead. Pirates at the plate now, top of the third. Eric Gonzalez at the dish, 3-0 count. He draws himself a walk, so he's over on first with one out, as then Chris Archer comes to the plate, lays down a sack bunt, fielded by Tyler Austin, flips it over to Samardzija, who's covering first, so it's runner on second now with two outs, and Starling Marte is going to hit a slow roller into the right center field gap. That is an easy RBI triple for Starling Marte, the fleet-footed Marte, and it's a tie ball game at one. Move on to the top of the seventh, where Travis Bergen comes on, and he's going to hang a pitch to Gregory Polanco, and he does not miss that. Into the right field seats, El Coffey ties this or puts the Pittsburgh Pirates up 2-1 with his 9th home run of the season. Carlos Navas then comes on to the top of the 7th. He is facing Marte. Gotta get him looking on the up and in fastball, 96 miles an hour on the gun. That is Navas' his first career major league strikeout. And then with two outs brings up Josh Bell. He's gonna go down looking on the splitter. So it's still a 2-1 game, top of the ninth now. Pat Venditti, the ambidextrous pitcher, comes on, and he would get Gregory Polanco to go down on the 86 miles an hour fastball. Bottom of the eighth now, or bottom of the ninth, Felipe Vasquez comes on for the Pirates. Buster Posey at the dish with one out, and he is going to swing in a 2-2 pitch and hit it hard off the left field wall. He's going to have to hustle into second base, and he does just that, slides head first. In with a double, Franklin Barreto then comes on to pinch run with a one-run lead the Pirates have, and Ryan Schimpf gets a hanging slider that he somehow just gets under and pops it up the first base. He was not happy about that one. And then Tyler Austin chops one back to the pitcher Felipe Vasquez, and that's going to be the ball game as the Pittsburgh Pirates win this one 2-1 here over the Giants. Chris Archer got player of the game honors. He went 7 innings strong, only gave up 3 hits and 1 earned run, struck out 3 as well. Travis Bergen gets the loss for that home run he gave up to Polanco in the 7th inning. Not a very high action game, but the Pirates do get the win nonetheless. And before we move on to the final game of the episode, another thing happened, and that is Buster Posey fractured his leg with about a couple weeks left in the season, so he is going to miss the rest of the year. Luckily, it wasn't too bad of a break, so he is going to be back for next year, no problemo. Still here in San Fran, as the Giants are going to be playing host to an NL West foe in the Colorado Rockies. On the hill for the Giants is the sinker-balling left-hander Derek Holland, making his 31st start. And then on the hill for the Rockies is Germán Márquez. Rockies lineup, of course, led by Blackman and Arenado in the 3-4 spots, and the Giants lineup with a lot of changes, most notably Aramis Garcia, who is squatting behind the plate like a frog for today's ballgame. Bottom half of the first inning, Andrew Applin leading off the game, and he is going to hit a ball just barely over the wall in right field, a solo shot for the unlikely power of Andrew Applin. So 1-0 Giants is the lead. Brandon Belt then comes to the plate, hits what looks like a ground ball into the shift, but the second baseman has some trouble with it, and Brandon Belt is able to beat it out. That would bring up Ryan Schimpf, who has been absolutely tearing the cover off the ball in his last five games, and he continues to do so. Absolutely tattooed into McCovey Cove, a splash hit for Ryan Schimpf, the big power bat, and that is going to be his 30th home run of the season, the big 3-0, 428 feet off the bat. So it's a 3-0 lead as we move on to the top of the third, where Trevor Story is going to hit a ball up the middle for a base knock. Two outs, Charlie Blackman at the plate now. He's going gapping right center field. No one's going to be able to cut that one off. And Blackman easily drives in Story from first base with an RBI triple, and the Rockies have themselves on the board. Nolan Arenado would then line out right at Ryan Schimpf, showing off some cat-like reflexes on the defensive side of the ball. And in the top of the fourth now, Brendan Rodgers is going to hit a ball past the glove of Brandon Belt in left field, just did not catch it for whatever reason. So Rodgers on second base. And Ian Desmond then comes to the plate, hits the ball into right field for a base knock. Runners on the corners, as they do not test the arm of the right fielder, so runners on the corners, one out, and Chris Iannetta gets a pitch to hit, and he does not miss. Makes Holland pay for that one, as it's now a 4-3 Rockies lead with one swing of the bat from the catcher Chris Iannetta. Eighth home run of the season for him. Tyler Beede, the pride of Worcester, Massachusetts, comes on in. Bases loaded jam he comes into. Gets Charlie Blackman to line out to left field. And then Nolan Arenado, not an easy task for Beede coming into this game, but he does get out of it. Gets Arenado to pop up in the foul territory. And then in the top of the fifth, he's in a jam as well. Runners on second and third with one out. He walks Iannetta, so it's bases loaded for the pitcher. Márquez lines out at Schimpf at third base. Now there's two down. Brings up the always dangerous Trevor Story at the top of the lineup. 1-0 count to him. He's going to pop a ball up into shallow left field. Brandon Crawford's back for that one, and he puts it away. Beede gets out of another jam to keep the score at 4-3. Bottom of the fifth now. Aramis Garcia walks to lead off the bottom of the fifth. Chris Shaw will then come on to pinch hit for the pitcher, and he's going to hit a ball into right center field. That's hard up against the wall. Garcia is going to score all the way from first base. The catcher showing off some wheels. That's an RBI triple for Chris Shaw, another Massachusetts native on this ball club. And then the suicide squeeze is on, but it's a high pitch, so Applin cannot get the bunt down. A terrible, terrible mistake there, as it is still going to be a 4-4 tie moving on to the top of the sixth. So Kieran Lovegrove on, gives up a hit to Craig Gentry to lead off the inning. So he's on first. A pitch to Charlie Blackman is then in the dirt, gets away from Ronis Garcia. A passed ball, it is scored. So Gentry over on second. 3-1 count to Blackman. Hits a line drive into center field. Andrew Applin showing off some defensive prowess with an over-the-shoulder catch. Gets the ball in quickly, but the runner does tag up. And then Arenado, ground ball to shortstop. The infield was not in, so the run will come in to score. 5-4 Colorado now. Melvin Adone comes on top of the seventh, one out, facing Ian Desmond. A slider that did not slide is going to be pulverized. Dead center field, a solo shot for Ian Desmond of all people, and it's now a two-run lead for the Rockies, 6-4. Trevor got on for the top of the eighth, runner on second, one out, and a pitch to Nolan Arenado.
It was at this moment he knew. He fucked up.
Gonna be in the dirt, throw over to third, and then throw back to first. I don't even know what happened there, but it's runners on the corners. with one out, and it's going to be a ground ball play, what appears to be a ground ball play, but Daniel Murphy runs faster than he ever has in his life to beat it out, so the run comes in. 7-4 now is the score. Wade Davis on, facing Ryan Schimpf with two outs, and bam! Another mistake to Ryan Schimpf, and that's going to be two splash hits in the same game for Ryan Schimpf. Might as well call it Schimpf Cove. Don't do that. It's disrespectful. 31st home run of the season. Take another look at this swing. Beautiful swing. He's still watching it. Taking another look, and then he flips the bat. Guess who doesn't like that? Brian McCann on the bench for this game. He's watching it from the dugout. He's looking, oh man, how far is this one going to go? Ah, I can't believe Davis just gave that up. And he's sad. Head down, not very good. He's ready to enforce those unwritten rules because he is a wannabe cop.
Am I the only one around here who gives a shit about the rule?
But it was too little too late for the Giants as the Rockies get the win 7-5 in this one here over the Giants at Oracle Park. Ian Desmond, of all people, gets Player of the Game honors. He was 4-for-5 in the day as the Giants just could not get him out. Chris Iannetta, 2-for-4 with a home run. Charlie Blackman was 2-for-5. Daniel Murphy was 1-for-5. And then Ryan Schimpf was the big offense for the Giants on the day. Two home runs, both of them into McCovey Cove. And with that being said, that's going to wrap things up here for this edition of the San Francisco Giants franchise. This is the final gameplay episode of the 2019 season. Next episode, we'll be wrapping up the season, taking a look at stats, taking a look at the playoffs, who makes the playoffs, going over everything that happened at the end of the season, and then moving on into the offseason where we will finally do that. And then the next episode of that will be a 2020 regular season episode. So I've been your host, Jerseyborn, and I am saying, Kenny!